Today concept name is detailed Java. First definition, variable. Already we discussed variable. Last concept of overloading, right? Sorry, string class, right? Last class, string class, right? Madam?
Yeah.
Last class, string class only?
Yes. String class.
Yes, string variable. Class. What do you mean by variable? Variable is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location. Which can hold a value, the value will be changed in future. That is variable. Variable is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location. Which can hold a value, the value will be changed in future. Number of times, how many times you want, that many times we can change the value, so that is called variable. This is the variable memory location. I am giving name is A equal to 10. Variable advantages. Reusability. Easy to update, easy to maintain. That is variable definition. Variable syntax. Data type. Variable name equal to value. Data type variable name equal to value. So then we can write simple int a equal to 10. So this is the variable definition. Variable is nothing but it is a name given to a memory location which can hold a value. The value will be changed in future number of times. How many times you want, that many times we can change the value. That is variable. Next, constant. It is a name given to a one memory location, which can hold a value, the value will be, will not change in future. That is constant. Constant is nothing but it is a name given to a one memory location which can hold a value. That value will not change in future. So the value will not change in future. So variable, constant syntax. Final, data type, constant name equal to value. Final, into a equal to 10. So this is the constant. How we know? Just whenever you are facing the interview, that time they may ask you like, how we know which one is variable, which one is constant? How we know? So if it is having final, that is constant. If it is not having final, that is variable. If it is having final, that is constant. If it is not having final, that is variable. That is the difference between variable and constant. Right. Next, variables. There are two types of variables. One is local variables. Local variables means within the function only it will work. Beyond the function, it will not work. Beyond the function, it will not work. Within the function only it will work, beyond the function it will not work. That is called local variable. Next, global variables. Global variables. Global variables further divided into four types. Very, very important this one. Global variables further divided into four types. One is public. Public, default, private, protected. So there are four types of global variables: so public, default, private, protected. Public, default, private, protected. So public, once if you write public before that function, if you write public, we can access in entire project. If we write public, we can access that function in the entire project. If it is under default package, if you are not taking any package, it will take under default package. So that function we can access in only package only. If you write private, we can access in the class only. If you write protected, we can access in that particular package. As well as we can access from other packs child class stuff also. These are the access modifiers. In Java, we have four access modifiers. Public, default, private, protected. If you write public, we can access in entire project only. If it is under default package, we can access in package only. If it is private, we can access in class only. If it is protected, we can access in package, as well as we can access from other pack child class files. That is variables. Next, conditional statements. One is for loop. Conditional statement. First, if condition. Where exactly we will use it? If it is only single block, we will use it. If it is only single block, we will use if condition. If a is equal to 10, ugly is a good bug. So there is no other alternate. Next, if else. Among two blocks, if you want execute, only one block, we will use if else. If a is equal to 10, Akhil is a good boy. Else, Akhil is a bad boy. If A is equal to 10, at least a goodbye, else at least a bye bye. So if A is equal to 10, it will execute at least a goodbye. If A is not equal to 10, it will execute at least a bad bye. Among two blocks, if you want execute only one block, that time we will use if else. Among two blocks, if you want execute only one block, we will use if else. Next, switch case. Among many blocks. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, that time we will use switch case statement. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, that time we will use switch case statement. So here we have many blocks. Here we have many blocks. So selectively we can execute. Choice 1, choice 2, choice 3. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, that time we will use switch case statement. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, that time we will use switch case statement. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, that time we will use switch case statement. Among many blocks, if you want execute selectively some blocks, choice 1, choice 2, choice 3, then we can write it. So selectively we can select and we can execute. So this is called switch case statement. Next, looping statements. Looping statements. Next, looping statements. Very, very important. Concentrate. Looping statements. Looping statements. Looping statements. Where exactly we will use looping statements? If you want to execute a certain block of statements continuously or repeatedly, then we will use looping statements. If you want to execute a certain block of statements continuously or repeatedly, then we will use looping statements. If you want to execute a certain block of statements continuously or repeatedly, we will use looping statements. If you want to execute a certain block of statements continuously or repeatedly, then we will use looping statements. There are three looping statements available in Java. There are three looping statements. One is for loop. Where exactly we will use for loop? If you want to execute, if you know how many fixed number of times, how many fixed number of times that loop should be executed. If you know how many fixed number of times that loop should be executed, if you know figure or number, if you know figure or number, figure or number, number, we will use for loop. How many fixed number of times that loop should be executed? If we know that figure or number, then we will use for loop. For example, for into I equal 0, I less than 20 times, I plus plus. If you know this figure, then only we can use for loop. 20, if you know this 20, then we can use for loop. How many fixed number of times the loop should be executed? If you know figure or number, then we can use this for loop. Next, compulsory, if you know figure or number, then only we can use for loop. Next, while loop. Next, while loop. Next, while loop. Next while loop. Where exactly you use while loop? As long as condition being satisfied. As long as condition being satisfied. This loop is called entry level condition. Here is no restriction like 10 times, 20 times. So no restrictions. As long as condition being satisfied. As long as condition being satisfied, it will execute to this loop is called entry level condition. With example, each and every one example I will teach you in future. In Java only we can get it. In Selenium also we can get it. But each and while loop, do while loop, for loop, where exactly we will use for loop, everything I will explain you later. This loop is called entry level condition. Next, do while. Just similar to while. Just similar to while. Just similar to while. Just similar to while. But without checking the condition, without checking the condition, it will execute first time. Without checking the condition, it will execute first time. Second time onwards. It will check the condition. It will check the condition. So this loop is called exit level condition. This loop is called exit level condition. Exit level condition. This loop is called exit level condition. Next concept, array. What is array? Array is nothing but it is a special type of variable. Which can hold the multiple values. Array is nothing but it is a special type of variable which can hold the multiple values. Which can hold the multiple values. This is array. Just like it is special type of variable, which can hold the multiple values. If you want to store the multiple values, we will use array. If you want to add anything to array, if you want to get anything from array, we will use index concept. 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 Array index start with 0. 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 This is a very very important point. Array index start with 0. Array index start with 0. If you want to add anything to array, if you want to get anything from array, we will use index concept to array index start with 0. Array index start with 0. Array index start with 0. Right. There are three types of arrays. One is single dimension array. Second one is multi-dimensional array. Third one is object array. Single dimensional array syntax. Data type, array name equal to new data type size of array. Into a equal to new int size of array 5. We can write it into a equal new int 5. Single dimensional, multi dimensional int a equal to int a equal to new int 4 rows 5 columns. This is multi-dimensional array. Next object array. Object array, who should be cap? Object array. What is use of object array? If you want to store the, if you want to store the multi-data types, if you want to store the multi-data types, we will use object array. If you want to store the multi-data types, we will use object array. Object array syntax. What should be cap object A equal to new object size of array 4. A of 0 equal to Akhil. It is a string data type. A of 1. 10 integer data type. A of 2 equal 0.004. A of 3 equal to single character. No, sorry. Right. So here we have four data types only. One is integer data type, string data type, and decimal data type, and character data type. So if you want to store the multi-data types, you will use object array. Object array is used for store the multi-data types. If you want to store the multi-data types, we will use object array concept. So using this concept, we will discuss the remaining Java concepts. Array is very, very important. Array index start with 0 also very, very important. Array index start with 0. That is very, very important. Right. Today concept name is exception only. Today concept name is exception only. Exception only. What do you mean by exception? While writing the Java code, while writing the Java code, there are some chances the code which we have written can't execute it by Java. So such type of situation is known as exception. While writing the Java code, there are some chances the code which we have written can't execute it by Java. So after writing the code, sometimes Java will not execute. So that is called an exception. Simple. While writing the Java code, there are some chances the code which we have written can't execute it by Java. So such type of situation is known as exception. Right. After writing the code, sometimes Java will not execute code. So that is called exception. What do we do by? Oh, so there are two exceptions. One is caught exception. C-A-U-G-H-T. Caught exception. Other one is uncaught exception. Caught exception, uncaught exception. What do you mean by caught exception? While writing the Java code, If at all any missing, if at all any missing, any missing means any spelling mistake, bracket, semicolon. If at all any missing, Java will show you. Underline, comma, or into mark, or error message. That is called cut exception. By writing the Java code, if at all any missing, Java will show you underline or into mark or error message. That is called cut exception. If it is showing underline or error message or into mark, so we can alert and we can rectify the problem. Why? What's wrong here? Why it is showing underline? Something is wrong. What happened? What's wrong? So we can alert and we can rectify the problem. If you don't know this, we will call to our friends or we will ask the doubt. Why it is showing line? I wrote a script like this, but it is showing error. Why it is showing error? We can ask the doubt. And or we can go to Google and we can search it. Why it is showing underline? Why it is showing error? Why it is not executing? We can get it easily. We can alert and we can rectify the problem at any cost. That is called cut exception. Cut exception, it is not big issue. If it is showing underline, something is wrong. What's wrong? We can alert and we can rectify the problem. Next, uncut exception. Uncut exception. While writing the Java code, if at all any missing, Java will not show you anything. Java will not show you anything. Simply it will sit. Simply it will sit. During execution, it will not execute. That is called uncut exception. That is called uncut exception. So, uncut exception means by writing the Java code, if at all any missing, Java will not show you anything. Simply, it will sit to during execution, it will not execute. So, that is called uncut exception. If you want to find out the uncut exceptions, we will use try, catch, final. We will use try, catch, final. Where exactly we will use try? If you have doubt on any particular block of statements, if you have doubt on any particular block of statements, it's just better to keep in try block. If you have doubt on any particular block of statements, it's just better to keep in try block. What is that error we can get in catch block? What is that error we can get in catch block? What is that error we can get in catch block? What is that error we can get in catch block? Finally, at any cost, it will execute. If it is try executing or not, catch executing or not, at any cost, it will execute. Finally, at any cost, it will execute. Try executing or not, catch executing or not, at any cost, it will execute. So that is called finally. Where exactly we will use try? If you have doubt on any particular block of statement, just better to keep it try block. What is that error we can get in catch block? What is that error we can get in catch block? Finally, at any cost, it will execute. If it is try executing or not, catch executing or not, at any cost, finally it will execute. So, sir, you said if you have doubt on any particular block of statements, it's just too better to keep in try block, you say. I have doubt on multiple blocks. So, that time, what I should do, what I need to do. So, multiple times we should write try, multiple times we should write catch. So, program will be lame. Program will be lame. Instead of try and catch, always we will use throws. We will use throws. We will use throws. We will use throws. Throws is nothing but it is a predefined class in Java. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. Okay, throws is nothing but it is a predefined class in Java. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. What is the main drawback in try and catch? If you have doubt on only particular block, this is better to keep it try block. That is not the issue. So if you have doubt on multiple blocks, that multiple times we should write try, we should write catch. So program will be lengthy. Instead of try and catch, always we will use throws. Throws is nothing but it is a predefined class in Java. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. It can handle the thousands of exceptions at a time. So that is the concept of exception handling. That is the concept of exception handling with you. Code I will show you now. Program. Go to src, take the new class, class name is ex, click on finish. Okay, SYSO control space, concentrate this concept, you can get it, what is the logic of Java, you can get it today. Concentrate, concentrate. If you have any doubt, ask me. Feel free, friendly. You can ask any doubt. I am declaring one array into A equal to new into, I'm giving size is 5. Concentrate, concentrate, concentrate. Okay, right. I declared one array. A of 2 equal to 200. A of 5 equal to 1000. I am writing. So there is no semicolon. So this is called cart exception. I missed semicolon. So that is called cart exception. So if it is showing underline, what's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong? What's wrong? Okay, here it is showing syntax error. Insert semicolon. Okay, right, right. We can alert and we can rectify the problem. So that is called cart exception. In these two lines, we have one uncart exception. What is that? In these two lines, we have an uncart exception. What is that? All that I told you. In this two line, we have uncart exception. What is that?
A 5000.
Why error?
Before you didn't get the semicolon, that's why you got the error. Now it was like three decimals.
No. Logic. Already I told you array index start with 0. Actually array index start with 0. I gave size is 5. Array index start with 0. I gave size is 5. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4.
4.
Okay. Size is 5 is over. Whenever I am writing 5, it need to show error. But it is not showing an error. So this is called uncart exception. That is called uncart exception. Okay. Actually array index start with 0. So the size I mentioned 5. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 5 is over. So whenever I am writing 5, it need to show error, but it is not showing an error. So that is called uncaught exception. Right. So that's the reason I am keeping try block. What is that error I want to find out? What is that error I want to find out? So what is that error? It will show you now. Save. Click on run. Error is 5. What is 5? I don't know index concept. So if you want to know clear console, here we will use e dot print stock phrase. What is that error? it will show in console very clear manner. Save, click under. Okay, Java long array index out of band exception 5. So Java long array index out of band exception 5. So it will show the error. Array index out of band exception. Array index array long array index out of band exception 5. Right. Next, finally. At any cost it will execute. If you try executing or not, catch executing or not, it will execute. SYSO control space. Tata. Tata. SYSO control space. Bye. Now, save. Click on run. So long. Java long array index out of band exception 5. Good morning 5. Good morning 5. Bye. Tata coming. Okay. Hello Java not coming. Why it is not coming? Hello Java. First logic. Tell me. Hello Java not printing. Why it is not printing? Hello Java. First logic. Hello Java, it is not printing. Why it is not printing? Hello Java. Here, observe carefully. Whenever the exception occur, it will not come, it will not execute remaining blocks. So here exception occurred. So it will come to catch block. It will not execute remaining blocks. That is the logic. There is exception. There is exception. When the exception occurs, it will come to catch block. It will not execute remaining blocks. That is the logic. That is the logic. So it will not print to hello Java. Okay. That is first logic. Second logic. Here I am giving size 6. If I click on run, it will execute good morning, hello Java, Tata coming, bye not coming. Why bye not coming? Why not coming? Why it is not coming, boy? Why? Because here is no exception. I gave size is 6, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay. There is no exception. There is no exception. So it will not come to catch block. It will not come to catch block. So directly we go to finally. That is the concept. Exception only. That is the concept exception only.